Erev Tov, Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Has some very serious things going on in and around Israel. All types of things are heating up there. On Sunday afternoon, again, Gaza has fired rockets into Israel. One of them landing in an unpopulated area. The other one actually didn't even make it out of Gaza. Fell short, fell inside the Gaza territory there. And of course, another one was intercepted even before that time. We've had the terrorist activity. We've had four people murdered already by ISIS, one or two more wounded, and a fifth one, not ISIS, but by the Arab Palestinians there in the land. Now we have even more breaking news, and this is coming out on a number of sites going on right now in Europe, throughout Europe and throughout different parts in the Middle East there, that Russia, and this is on, I'm pulling this one off of the Express UK's website, it's a news website there, .co.uk, said that Russia is going to end, will be the end of ISIS. Putin is sending in 150,000 soldiers to Syria to wipe out the evil Islamic State. The article here reads here that the Russian leader is reportedly mounting an enormous military mission to take control of the terror group's stronghold in Raqqa. The city is the self-declared capital of ISIS in Syria and is patrolled by as many as 5,000 jihadi members. Putin is set to mobilize 150,000 reservists who is conscripted into military earlier this week. That will only allow the president to use his own forces to send them in while reservists can help protect the homeland of Russia, no doubt. That's one of the things that the president has done in the past. When he brings in more military power, he keeps those back home while he sends the better forces up on the battle lines. Now, why would Russia need 150,000 soldiers to take out ISIS if they've only got 5,000 patrolling? It seems like that we may very well have the beginning of the Gog and Magog war if we definitely do have a double fulfillment of this prophecy of Ezekiel 38, right on the edges of it there. We see that also Iran and Iraq also are joining with Russia. Again, as I have said in the past there, it appears to me that the Vatican has a new warlord, and that warlord is Vladimir Putin, without a doubt there. He is Catholic himself, Russian Orthodox, and this is only going to create more and more problems. We'll be keeping you up to date as more of these stories do develop here. Again, a very serious situation there in Israel. The President Putin, and I support him in the Ukraine issue there. I even support the fact that he's trying to destroy ISIS. But I do have a concern when it comes to Israel. Is it going to stay contained there, or is there going to be spillover into the Golan? Because no doubt Bashar Assad would love to see the Golan go back under Syrian control, and they may allow it to spill over just for the purpose of being able to get it. And of course, the reason being, they want to get the oil of this region here. I have to agree with Avi Lipkin on that point right there. He says the New World Government is going to take out ISIS in order for the oil fields there. It has nothing to do with Jews or Christians when it comes to that. It has to do with the oil and the natural gas in that region there. And it, don't forget, Putin has already signed an agreement with Mahmoud Abbas for the West Bank's oil and natural gas as well. So he is definitely there to get his stronghold there, and it's a tremendous alarm for us, to say the very least. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Shalom. Be good night.